The government wants to reverse changes that made it easier for iwi to gain customary title over coastal areas. The bill attempting to do that will be back in the spotlight on Tuesday as the amendment to the Marine and Coastal Areas Act goes to select committee. Reporter Whena Owen takes a look at how the controversial legislation has tracked.
Hi there. Well, a lot of you have contacted us either online or through the Facebook site or contacted my office in writing or rung about concerns over the coastal area and marine bill.
It's December 2010. The summer holidays are just around the corner, and so is a new bill outlining the processes by which iwi could potentially claim customary marine title. In some quarters, there's panic, followed by calm reassurance from the top.
You'll still be able to go to the beach, have your barbecue, catch a fish, do all the things that you've done in the past.
The Marine and Coastal Areas Act, Takutai Moana, was passed in 2011. Now the tides come in again on the issue of customary marine title.
A customary marine title grants rights over resource consents, conservation and ownership of various minerals and protected objects in their area. But title holders can't sell the land, and the title has no effect on public access, swimming, fishing and other recreational activities. Oh,
20 years ago, 20,000 people marched in opposition to the Foreshore and Seabed Bill, which took away the pathways for Māori to gain customary title. Under the Clark Labor government, the Act stated that the Crown is the owner of the Foreshore and Seabed.
The Associate Māori Affairs Minister's weighing up her future with the Foreshore legislation due out next week.
MP Tariana Turia ditched the Labor Party over the controversial act and founded the Māori Party. In coalition with the Key government, the Māori Party helped shape the bill that replaced the Foreshore and Seabed Act. It restored the right of Māori to seek customary interests.
All New Zealanders who were not affected by the 2004 Act, nothing will change for them. But those that were affected by it now have two avenues by which they can seek their rights.
Under the 2011 Act, Māori could potentially seek customary rights through the courts or directly with the Crown. The Act Party launched a campaign against the bill.
I've been hearing from both iwi and non-iwi that they don't want this bill.
It's important for the nation to settle these issues so it does not remain as a weeping sore that would have to be addressed at some stage by a future government.
Whoops. The Marine and Coastal Areas Act is back and getting a makeover.
The sole purpose of these amendments is to ensure that balance continues to be struck and is an enduring one for Māori and for all New Zealanders.
It's a response to a landmark Court of Appeal decision last year awarding customary marine title to a range of hapū in Eastern Bay of Plenty. Then, guided by that precedent, earlier this year, the High Court granted iwi groups along the southern Wairarapa coast customary marine title. The area extends 150 kilometres from Turakirai Head off the Wainuiomata coast up to just north of Riversdale. The government says those groups already awarded will retain their customary title, but there are another 200 or so claims moving slowly through the courts. They will miss out if and when the bill is passed.
The proposal to have this done by the 5th of December, if I recall the date correctly, the 5th of December of this year, once again shows that when it comes to matters relating to Māori, oh, it's okay to have a truncated process.
Labour, Greens and Te Pāti Māori oppose the bill. New Zealand First support it. It was part of a coalition agreement with National. They want solid evidence of an iwi's connection to an area.
Rather than allowing claims based solely on just cultural or spiritual associations.
The bill sets the bar much higher to the granting of customary titles. Applicants must prove they have exclusively used and occupied an area since 1840. Those are the key words, exclusive use and occupation.
Last month, a Waitangi Tribunal report about the proposed changes to the Act found that the government has failed to consult with Māori.
The Tribunal has said that this is a clear breach from this government in terms of treaty rights. Why don't we just follow that process?
The government hopes to have the bill passed by early December. Submitters have until midnight this Tuesday to have their say.